Welcome, gamers. Welcome back to Gamers Bay. It's Daniel, and today we're going to check out Midnight Wanderer's Quest for the Chariot. Now, this run-and-gun arcade platformer was actually part of Capcom's Three Wonders, which was basically a compilation of three classic arcade games all in one. One of the games was a side-scrolling aerial shoot-'em-up, another was a puzzle game, and then there's this one, the platformer, which we're going to check out today. So in Midnight Wanderers, players take on the role of a hobbit named Lou, who's been fighting to try and take down the evil entity known as Gaia, who's been turning his people into wooden statues. Now, upon his quest, he also seeks to find the legendary Chariot of Light, for which legend has it, which it said, he who rides the chariot will fly high above the earth and into the heavens. Now, another reason that he needs to find this chariot is because it's the only means possible for him to put a stop to Gaia's campaign of terror upon his people. Now, this Hobbit Lou, he looks somewhat like a Keebler elf fighting an assortment of characters, most notably other elves throughout the course of the game. Now, Lou also has this sort of a helper character named Siva, who provides him with a secondary shot that helps to repel incoming enemy attacks. And it's actually quite effective. Now, players also battle it out against an assortment of other characters in the game, including a demonic-looking mechanical puppet with strings, believe it or not, as well as a flying witch, bats, demonic-looking moons, and there's even this giant green blob character that looks strikingly similar to Jabba the Hut. Now, let's go ahead and talk a little bit about the boss characters. So the first thing to note about the bosses in this game is that, well, several of them you actually fight more than once throughout the course of the game. Bosses include a demonic-looking tree character named Golem Wood, which is the boss character shown here. He's really creepy looking. Another one, Balgoss, is an alien creature that looks like something out of the Star Wars franchise. Now, I don't know what it is about this game, but it honestly seems like the developers took a lot of inspiration from the Star Wars series when developing this game. Now, other bosses include these characters called Laru, which are actually a pair of monsters that you're forced to battle simultaneously. Then there's this egg-like character named Dumpty, an obvious reference to Humpty Dumpty, the classic storybook character. And he definitely fits the character, as it just looks like a pair of eggs. Then there's a boss named Duggar, who looks like some weird alien creature with a really giant arm that throws a giant dagger at you. Then there's a boss named Moban, which is a giant spherical creature. It actually looks like a planet surrounded with spikes. And then, of course, there's the final boss, which is known as Gaia, the God of Earth, and he looks really creepy. Now, the gameplay follows the typical run-of-the-mill classic run-and-gun, side-scrolling, jumping platform-to-platform type gameplay. Now, on the downside, there's no diagonal aiming with your gun in this game, making it really quite challenging to target enemies with such linear abilities. It would have been nice if they had added in some ability to have some sort of omnidirectional aiming. So on the plus side though, you do have a short dash maneuver that can help you to steer out of the way of incoming enemy attacks, though it's not very effective. So anyways, that is Midnight Wanderer's Quest for the Chariot. I honestly thought this was a really great game with really compelling graphics for the time. Keep in mind, this game came out back in 1991. I mean, this was really state-of-the-art. Most games couldn't compare with this. They just really couldn't. Now, I also really do feel like the game took a lot of inspiration from the Star Wars series, but maybe it's just a coincidence, who knows. So anyways, I'm going to go ahead and tune out now, but I'm going to continue to play through the game, and you're welcome to continue to watch, and until next time, take care.